Hey y'all, it's Danielle Ty. Thank y'all for tuning in. Happy Thursday. I really wanted to get on here and low-key vent, but it's not venting because I'm not mad at anybody. But, you know, my friend had brought up the topic of gossiping to me, and it just had me thinking of, like, when I hear the word gossip, what do I think about? And a cold part is the first thing I think about is family. Like, do you realize that family feel like they are the main people who are entitled to talk about you? They are entitled to gossip about you. They are the first ones to gossip about you. And it's crazy because it's like this shit really do come from like a hater mentality, right? You could be this person who want to change. You're changing. You have changed. And those same people who seen you at your worst, you know, during your worst was praying, hoping, and getting on you about doing better. And once you are doing better, they try to hold you to who you were when you were doing bad. Like, look at them, look how they act, and they think they this. They think they so much better. They act like they got it all together. I remember when they used to act like this, or they used to do that. You know, or they'll know that you need to change something about yourself, and instead of telling you from a place of love, they talk shit to you about it, or never even mention it to you. They talk to everybody else about it. What's the name? Always doing this. What's the name? Always talking shit. They need to do this. Do you know they do this all the time? They need to do that. I don't know why they do that. And it's just crazy. That's like, from after getting out of school, you know, thinking that you're done with the gossiping and stuff. It's crazy how it's like you really still can be consumed in that from your family. And it's like, I seen a meme that said, people be real life depressed, but afraid to talk to people about it because they scared that people gonna gossip about them. People, you know, you scared people gonna talk shit about you. People don't even want to be vulnerable because it's like you worried about what everybody else gonna say. And it's sad too. Man, I remember how I used to be. You know, I never been the type of person to gossip. I like to talk about aliens and conspiracy and shit, so I don't like small talk, gossiping a small talk. But I definitely felt like I was the type of person who always kept it a honey, you know, tough love, keeping it, you know, I'm just letting them know what they need to hear. And it didn't come from, you know, kindness. It definitely came from a place of love, but it was, like I said, it was tough love. That's the way that I wanted to, you know, to receive advice or something. So that's what I dished. And the only reason that I wanted it that way is because I needed to wake up. I'm sure whatever I needed advice about most likely was something I was brainwashed about. Something that I needed somebody to convince me to help me get out of that. So it's like, kindness and stuff ain't gonna work with me. I want you to tell me, hey, get it together. You looking stupid. You looking pathetic out here. What's like, that's the only way it would have registered to me. I just didn't resonate with that. Danielle, you know you're better than this. You deserve more. I don't want none of that. So I didn't want none of that. So at the time, that's not what I was going to give. I was treating people the way that I thought I wanted to be treated. The cold part is, you know, not everybody's going to resonate with that as well. Not everybody looks at that as help. Not everybody look at that as love. And it's just like, you know, no, I wasn't gossiping, but me giving my advice or my constructive criticism wasn't helping either. It's just crazy that it's like our loved ones feel like, you know, they can talk to strangers easier than they could talk to the people who love them. You know, you feel like you won't get no judgment from the people who don't know you. Or you won't get nobody who will hold you to who you used to be, how you used to be. You know, you don't have to convince nobody that you've changed. And it's just sad because we really need to change that. It's too many people out here who are depressed, who contemplate suicide. When all you really need is somebody to just talk to, somebody who can relate to. I mean, I be that same type of person who feel like I ain't got nobody to talk to. Nobody's going to understand. That main one is that nobody cares. That's what I be needing to work on. Nobody care. And that's not the thing, that everybody going through their own stuff. And I think that's what it was to them, me giving that tough love. Like, I was giving out tough love because I needed love, because I was trying to help people when I needed help. I was trying to give out advice when I needed advice. I was trying to give out love the only way that I knew how to give out love, because I wasn't getting the love that I needed. And that be the real core of it. You know what I'm saying? So instead of gossiping and you know, just having all that negativity in your life, if you really want to talk about somebody, talk about what you could do to make them better. Talk about what you could do to help. Because if you can't help and you just talking about somebody, it sounds like you need something better to do with your time. And the motherfuckers who be gossiping about people in real life be the people who really ain't got no place to talk. I seen a quote that really stuck with me hella long ago. I ain't gonna get it right, I already know, because I'm pretty sure they ain't saying no cussing and mine gonna have some cussing in it. But it basically said, like, small-minded people talk about small shit. Talk about irrelevant shit. Talk about other people. You know, people who is really, and I don't even know if they said small-minded. Look, is it called big-minded? But people who have better shit to talk about ideas. They talk about plans. They talk about changing their lives. They talk about innovative shit. You know what I'm saying? They're not just sitting down there talking about people. Did you see what she had on? Did you see what she said? Did you see what she... You know what I'm saying? Now, don't get me wrong. I get it keeping up with current events. But when that's all you do, or when you got people who love you, who really want to come to you and talk about something, but all you can do is gossip, you can't wait to get off the phone with them just so you could call somebody else and tell them what happened. We got to really reevaluate that shit. Because you better believe that if you do that, as soon as you tell somebody, you vent to somebody or get advice from somebody with something, that karma going to come back and they're going to be calling somebody else talking shit about you. That's how that shit work. But either way, I just wanted to talk about that real quick. I love y'all. Make sure y'all stay tuned for the next one. Peace.